By the way, you were mentioning the conspiracy theories and so on. Every day, Yuval, I receive so many new conspiracy theories about everything. I don't know if it's happened to you too. I mean, every day, I don't know, there is a new theory, and Bill Gates and the vaccine and flat Earth and 5G and the lab. Every day there is something new. I wanted to understand with your help, why there is such a spread of these conspiracy theories. There is this love for an alternative storytelling. Is something that you always we always saw in the history. In this moment, of course, social media helps spreading, but is
I
there
mean,
a solution there or not? Or we'll always have this kind of situation?
there are two reasons for the spread of conspiracy theories, especially in this kind of situation. First of all, is that people tend to blame their own problems on others, on foreigners, on minorities. We do it as individuals. We always blame the neighbors or my husband or my wife. I'm perfectly okay. He or she, they did something wrong. This is why we have this mess. So it's also on the level of epidemics, this tendency to blame somebody else and think there is a conspiracy. And we look at the Black Death that spread in the 14th century. So throughout Christian Europe, there spread this conspiracy theory that the Black Death was caused by Jews, a conspiracy, an international conspiracy of Jews to poison the wells of Christian communities. And they tortured several Jews in Europe and extracted confessions that people said, yes, we poisoned the wells. There is an international conspiracy. And this spread all over Europe. And there were huge pogroms in Germany, in what is today Switzerland, in Spain, in France, massacring entire communities because of this conspiracy theory. So what we see today with, like in India, blaming that the Muslims are deliberately spreading this coronavirus to hurt the Hindus, this is not something new. This has been long, long before in history. And the second reason why you see this spread of conspiracy theories is because, the human mind is lazy. It searches for simple stories. And the truth is complicated. Scientific truth, one of the hallmarks of scientific truth is that it's quite complicated. The human brain did not evolve to understand things like genetics and viruses. We went around in the African savanna trying to understand animals, big animals, elephants, lions, what they do, and trying to understand ourselves. There is somebody in the tribe who hates you, so be careful. This is the kind of thing that we can easily grasp. Now, the world of viruses has been completely invisible to us until basically the last century or two. Throughout history, nobody knew that a virus existed even. Just the thought that in a drop of water, you can have billions and billions of these pieces of information. They are not even living organisms. A virus is not a living organism. It doesn't eat. It doesn't reproduce by itself. It's basically just genetic code, a piece of code. And the idea that such things can go into our body, hijack our cells, and then multiply and destroy us, this was beyond the capacity of people to even imagine. And it's still very difficult today. So people look for a simple story. It's much simpler to think that the Jews are poisoning the wells, or the Chinese invented some virus to take over the world, or Bill Gates is spreading this to make a lot of money. This is the kind of thing that we easily grasp. Whereas the actual facts of epidemiology and virology, they are so complicated. And people don't like to feel stupid that I don't
Yes,
understand what's happening. So,
absolutely.
you have a nice conspiracy theory and you feel smart. Hey, I know what's happening. Now, I would say that as a general guideline, when somebody comes and tells you some conspiracy theory about COVID-19, first of all, ask this person to answer a simple question. Not so simple question, but a very important question. Please, before you explain to me all this conspiracy theory about the Chinese, please tell me what is a virus and how does a virus cause a disease? If a person cannot give you a clear explanation for that. Ignore everything else they say about the origin and spread of this epidemic.
I love the Yuval Noah Harari formula to spot fake news and conspiracy theories. I will use it. I will use it now, from now on. And also because you feel part of a tribe. And the crazy thing is that if you talk with someone who is 100% convinced about some kind of theory, the more you try to give them facts, the more they believe you are part of the system. Your friend, yeah. Bill Gates, is really paying you. You know, yes. How many people write to me and say, Bill Gates keeps paying you for your videos. I say, no, I never spoke with Bill. But, you know, people want to believe that way.
I mean, there are so many much easier ways to make money.
Yeah, absolutely.
Spread a pandemic and then create a vaccine. Yeah. I mean, it's ridiculous. I mean, he's smart, obviously, right?
And he's the richest man on earth. He's not poor. And he's also the richest man on earth.
Yes, I mean, it's not like he needs the extra billion for something. So, I mean, you know, many conspiracy theories, I mean, even if you accept their initial kind of logic, they have no internal consistency. Again, like this example that, okay, everything is being done to make money. Okay, that may be reasonable. But the idea that somebody could plan such a thing in advance, foresee all, you plant a virus somewhere, and you foresee how it will develop for months and months, and create this scheme to make money out of it. People are just not so very good in foreseeing the future consequences of what they do. You know, to take a real conspiracy as a counterpoint, think about the American invasion of Iraq in 2003. So here you can say, yes, you have the most powerful country in the world, with all the information from the CIA and whatever, coming up with this bogus claim that Saddam Hussein is behind 9/11 and is amassing weapons of mass destruction in order to take over Iraq and probably gain the oil, right? That's the story. Now, look what happened. They got into this terrible mess. They destroyed Iraq, all right, but they were basically kicked out. And the only result of all their efforts was that Iran took over. And this is, you know, it's not Bill Gates, just a private billionaire. This is the most powerful government in the world, with the biggest army, with the biggest intelligence service. And they completely misread the consequences of what they are doing. So do you think that somebody can really foresee what would be the consequences of spreading a pandemic throughout the world? I mean, this is really ridiculous to think that if somebody really has this power, then there is nothing we can do against it.
Yeah, it's Dr. Manhattan, and that's it. Better to surrender. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, if they have so much power, they can foresee all that. You think that you're going to stop them by putting some video on YouTube? I mean, really?